Hi and welcome back, it's Vicky here with the Tony Craft Kit number 12. So today I'm going to inspire you making 3 cards and I'm also going to do a quick unboxing so you can see what's included. I have to say that the Tony Craft Kits are always amazing and this is no exception. I'm going to show you all the products one by one, but always in a kit there is a mystery gift. I'm not going to show you what it is, but I want to show you one from a previous month. Because if you never got this kit, I want you to know that they are not joking about the mystery gifts. They are really good, handy, and you are always be happily surprised when you see what's included. So anyway, I am going to start with the Midas Touch Aqua Nouveau Flow Pen. This is gorgeous. You will see it in use and I will be using it on a card today. So all you need to do is to remove this yellow ring and then you need to screw it back inside until you hear the click. And then there is a place where it says push. You can see this is a real brush here. This is going to work as a watercolor pen, but at the same time it's going to add tons of glitter. Hopefully you can see here in the close-up how shiny it is. I will try to catch the light for you and probably you can see how gorgeous this looks. Now you can also mix it up with your watercolors for beautiful effects. I'm going to show you quickly here just a simple method and I will use the same technique again later on today for creating a lovely card. Now I used the purple aqua flow on a piece of watercolor cardstock and now I'm going to thin it down and make my paper really wet with just water brush. And then I'm going to squeeze my glitter pen on top and let a few of those drops fall onto the really wet paper. This is going to help the glitter spread inside the rest of the color. Everything is going to blend nicely. You can leave it as it is, nice and vibrant, or if you want a more subtle look, you can go ahead and just wipe off the excess and you get a beautiful result. Now this is an amazing product, I'm absolutely in love with it and I'm so happy that I got it in my kit. It is actually available separately and I will link everything down below in case you don't want to grab the whole kit and you just want this one. Now in the kit you also get a confetti pot, this is the rose gold sequins. I'm going to open it up for you, probably you can see the color better. I absolutely love this and I use them on my cards again and again. You know that I love creating shaker cards and these are the perfect elements. Now in the kit you also get this mini crystal drop. It's called Auburn Pearl and you can see how beautiful this color is. Matches perfectly with the papers you will see later on. And although it is a mini little pot, you can't believe how long it's gonna last you. After all, we only add a few drops on our projects here and there. You also get a mini pot with embossing powder and that's a copper blush. I'm going to open it up for you. Although you can't really tell the color, I will use it later on my cards and you will see the beautiful shine that you get. Now one of the best things about the Craft Kits by Tonic Studios is that you get to play first with new releases. So this is a brand new product, it's called Vintage Drops and the color that I have here is actually Vanilla Milkshake. This is a new range of Nouveau Drops that are going to dry matte. I love the matte finish and I'm sure that they are going to be quite popular when they hit the market, but for now we get to play first if we grab this craft kit. And that's not a mini version of the actual product, so you get lots and lots of product to use. And now let's take a look at the dies that you get this month as well as the stamp set. Of course you get a sticker, I like to stick it at the front just for the fun of it. Tons of dies in here, but let's see the stamp set first. So this is called Hello Autumn stamp set and it comes with 10 stamps. You get 2 sentiments, one that says lots of love and the other Hello Autumn, and little images such as a squirrel, a pine cone, an acorn and lots of leaves. Now let's take a look at the dies. I'm going to take them out of the envelope. And these are called Autumnal Shaker Card Layering Die Set. There are actually 39 dies. Just for the amount of dies, I think the kit can justify its price. So as you can see, all those dies nest inside the other. use them on your cards, on scrapbook pages, since they are quite big. You can even create leaf banners with them and decorate your home for fall. I think there are so many different ideas on how to use those. Make shaker cards, of course. And some of them actually have a scalloped edge around them. Some of these dies have lovely stitching. And here are tiny little leaves that you can use. If you are going for a shaker card theme, then you can cut out those little tiny leaves and add them as your shaker elements. And I'm just showing you here that some of those dies actually nest, the leaves nest one inside the other. I think that this is a really well thought die set, and you will have lots and lots of fun playing with it. And this is where I realized that two of those dies actually cut out the sentiments from the stamp set. I absolutely love this. And here is one more thing. There are dies that cut out all those tiny little images in the stamps, like the squirrel, the pine cone, the acorn, and the leaf. And here is another fun box inside, where you can find those plastic pouches in the shape of the leaf dies that you can use to create your shaker cards. Today I'm not going to make a shaker card because I know it is the obvious thing to do. I will make three different, totally different cards just to show you that there are so many different ways to use a shaker card kit. But also keep in mind that Tonic Studios will actually sell plastic pouches in this shape, so you can use your dies again and again and create as many shaker cards as you like. And finally, let's take a look at the cardstock. As you can see, it is absolutely gorgeous. You get glitter paper, you get mirror satin paper, embossed papers. I will link to all the products if they are separately available as well, in case you want to grab only specific things. But keep in mind that the dies and the stamp set are exclusive to this kit and you won't be able to grab them separately. So here are all the products included in the craft kit, and don't forget that you also get a mystery gift, which you will all love. So now we'll go ahead and make three cards just to inspire you, and I'm not going to make a shaker card since I know that this is the obvious solution, just to show you how else you can use the stamps and dies in the kit. So from the glitter paper I'm going to cut out one of those leaf dies, and from the other paper that was also in the kit I'm going to cut out that larger die twice. And for this card, I'm going for a leaf-shaped card, so I need to place that on my scoring board, and I'm going to score at the top where I want this to fold. So this is going to end up as a top-folding card. I have added double-sided tape only at the top part of this leaf where I have the fold. And then I'm going to place one on top of the other, make sure that I align them nicely. And then I'm going to stick those pieces together and I end up having a top folding leaf shaped card. I have added some foam tape at the back of the other die cut, the one with the glitter cardstock, and I'm going to place it on top just to embellish my card. And now I need to add the sentiment. For that I'm going to emboss the Hello Autumn, and I'm going to use the embossing powder that was included in the kit just to demonstrate the beautiful shine and color that you get. I'm using my stamping platform to get a good impression, stamped everything with Versamark ink, and then I'm going to apply my embossing powder, heat set it, and then of course I'm going to use the matching die since I have that in the set, and cut it out. And probably here you can see the beautiful copper shine that I get that is going to match with the colors of my card beautifully. And here is the matching die. I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. And before I stick the sentiment down, this is where I got the idea to tie a ribbon around that leaf. So thankfully I was able to lift it just a little bit to slide the ribbon underneath. And now I can stick my sentiment on top. I have some foam squares at the back to add more dimension. And here is the first card for today and some close-up photos. Here are the leftovers of cardstock that I used for the first card, and I'm going to use those to create my second card. So I'm going to cut out two panels. One is going to be the standard card size and the other one is going to be slightly smaller. So when I place one on top of the other, I get a lovely shiny border. On the smaller panel, I'm going to stamp my sentiment, and again I'm using the same sentiment and I'm going to emboss it. So I'm using Versamark ink and then I'm going to apply the same copper embossing powder from the kit. You can see the beautiful result here, and now I'm going to do some die cutting. I will choose some of the leaves from the set and I will be using only the inside from the nested leaves. I'm going to place them on my card and then run it through my Big Shot. You will see that I will get a beautiful design, and then I will repeat the same idea at the bottom of the card. So you see I get all those little windows in the shape of a leaf, and then when I place this on top of my glitter panel, then everything is going to be nice and shiny. And to put everything together, I used foam tape at the back of my top panel. Of course you can use white glue and stick them together, but you know that I always love dimension. And remember, you can use the same idea and turn it into a shaker card, but I promised in the beginning of the video that I won't be making any shaker cards for today. For the next card, I'm going for a watercolor look. So I'm working on a watercolor paper that I have already white embossed my sentiment, and I went with a sentiment from the kit that says lots of love. I have applied a little bit of indigo aqua flow, and now with a wet brush I'm going to spread it out. And now I'm using the gold glitter pen that was in the kit, and I'm adding dots of glitter all over the place. These are going to blend nicely with a wet color underneath. And since I want a more pale look, I'm going to lift the excess color with a paper towel. And I'm going to let this dry before I stick it on top of my card. Now my panel is dry and super shiny, and I have cut out a panel. I used one of the cardstocks from the kit that's called Copper Mine, and it has this beautiful satin look. I'm going to stick the panel on top. Now my card is pretty much finished, looks gorgeous as it is, but I am going to add some finishing touches. So with my Nouveau Deluxe I'm adding dots of glue, and then on top I'm going to add some of those hearts. You can punch those hearts out, you can use tiny little heart dies that you probably have on your stash, or you can just use your scissors and cut out hearts from the same copper cardstock as the base. And finally, I'm going to add some dots with the Nouveau Drops that was in the kit that match perfectly the card base. And finally, here are all the three cards that I made for today using products from the latest craft kit by Tonic Studios. And these were the cards for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment and let me know which one of those three cards was your favorite. And also remember that you can find the full list of all the supplies that I used down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and have a lovely day!